dedicato la mia vita ai momenti più felici, ad inseguire un sogno, il mio sogno. Quante volte mi hai deluso, non importa, io ci credo e vivo il mio sogno. Pari grande amore, pari unica e sola, pari nel nostro cuore, non ti lasceremo, ti lasceremo da sola. Facci sognare ancora.
Hello and welcome to the Staten Island Soccer Report featuring John Consaduca
and Brian Dorr.
Enjoy the show.
Excellent. What an introduction. That's a great
job. That was a good job, ladies.
All right. Welcome to the 77th Staten Island
77.
Soccer Report. 77 hours, right? Basically.
That is, wow.
I mean,
and I know, I think my first one was June of 14.
Wow.
Was the first one I did.
Yeah, I tell you, you know, we're just going to keep chugging along here. And I see we got a couple of...
We got a couple. I'm actually looking followers. I'm right. Going here and I'm just making sure I invite a bunch of people to know that we're live if they don't have their set
right.
up to
as
know
always,
that we're on.
As always, you know, welcome, Brian. You know, we could start off with... There's really not much going on on the youth side of things. With
no.
Easter holiday and Passover this past
outside
week.
Of just some practice.
Yeah, I mean,
you know?
So there's really, we could cut right to the chase.
I mean, outside, we'll just jump in. We talked about youth. We'll just jump at it real quick. Just a reminder, www.silverlakesoccer.com has everything listed. Their travel program, tryouts coming up, select boys and girls, clinics, everything there. Cedar Stars Academy website. I believe it's Cedar Stars Academy. .com,
yes.
Not to leave them out.
No.
That's the one thing. We try to be fair and equal to everybody. Go on, they have their tryouts coming up. So that's pretty much it. And then starting this week, I think it's full-blown rec starts again. And all youth goes, but now it's full-blown
right,
Staten Island
right.
Youth Soccer League. All the fields are open, right?
22nd, Miller Field will be back.
22nd, yes. The grand unveiling of Miller Field. I'm sure it's still as crappy as it was when it ended.
There's no improvements on that field.
You know.
But, we're back into full swing of things this coming weekend. And you know what? I just got a little bit of info. We may be doing some more shows.
Okay.
Like on a Monday, but I don't know if they're going to be live. I don't think we're going to be able to do live shows, but we're going to be doing some.
Listen, if we can get them in and it's taping, and we're doing fill-ins and taping.
We do live on Facebook,
and you know, people join us there from there. We'll invite everybody that we're doing it.
Say hello to Joe.
Joe's on. Joe's boys, if I'm not mistaken, because I saw him posting on Instagram. I believe his boys played down in the EDP Spring Showcase.
Okay.
Maybe he'll post and let me know how they did. But Joe's team, Cedar Stars, I believe they're U15, maybe U16.
Okay.
But Joe has a really good team, and I know they were down there. I saw him. He sure had a picture. They were at the tournament in the parking lot making their espresso early in the morning.
Yeah, you can't beat that, right? You got to have the espresso.
So,
all right. Brian, the show tag. If we could put it on the upper corner somewhere, maybe upper. No, we okay. He's saying we can't do
all
it.
All right.
Brian LaPierre behind the glass, and thank you to Kenny. Also, these guys
do a great job every week.
There's no show without them, so.
You know, and then Guy, when we do our off.
Guy also, right?
Off the cuff shows where we get in there to
fill in. Guy was actually here. He left early. He had to attend some business at home. So, Brian, on the youth side of things.
There's not much going on. We're going to jump in, but it's outside. Is really practicing right now.
Okay.
But there's nothing else. It kicks off coming next week. And again, while we're still on it, everything going kicking off next week. Clubs, local clubs. Don't wait. You know, nobody's reaching out to us from Staten Island Youth Soccer to give us any information. Feel free to post. You know, to send us messages on our Facebook page, and we'll post it. We'll, anything I find. A lot of the stuff I find, in Staten Island on Staten Island Live or the Advance, and
right,
I'll pick
right.
it and I'll share yep, out yep. whatever scores yep. are posted. But anything you want, we'll try to post it. Any soccer information regarding Staten
anything.
Island. And I see Joe.
Joe's got a question for you or a comment there.
Joe actually major gripe with the EDP tournament at Tuckahoe. They're turning it into a numbers game, jamming as many teams as they could into a tournament. Small fields and subpar satellite fields, which Joe's down there a lot more. We've only had the right. ability to be down there twice.
Right.
Once we were there for a full tournament,
right.
which, because it was the first time ever being there, was very impressive to us.
Right.
And then second, you guys, I wasn't there for that tournament. You guys got a shortened tournament because of rain.
The rain, yes.
But it sounds to me like they're trying, you know, there's a lot of tournaments going on.
Yeah, he's
and,
right.
Everybody wants to get their fill of teams, and the more teams, the more field, and it's a big complex.
It is.
For
tremendous.
Those of you that
tremendous.
Don't know about yeah. Tuckahoe Turf, it's actually that. It's a turf farm.
Right.
And they just, EDP rents it out, and they paint, yeah. they rent it out, and they put soccer fields all over the
tremendous
place. It's
amount.
Huge. I think
yeah.
they had numbered up to 34 or 35 fields when we were there.
Yep.
So they might be squeezing more in just to get games in,
right.
and then it becomes a sake of just playing games.
Right. Excellent, right. The fields yeah. are excellent.
They're excellent fields.
Right.
It's yeah. nothing like
no,
you're used
no,
to playing here on
no
Staten Island, you know.
Might be a little slow because of the high,
look,
right?
But it's,
a little
it,
bit
it,
on that,
change,
a little bit on the high grass.
It teaches you how to learn.
Right, right.
You know,
to,
you
got
to learn to play different ways. It teaches you to
right.
pace on
right.
the ball.
Right.
You know, I know as a father of a goalkeeper,
right.
she loved, when she was diving
she
on it in warm-up,
oh,
she
yeah.
loved it because it was like a mattress.
Right, right.
You know.
Okay.
So.
But speaking of your keeper, how's things going? Training?
Listen, I got my daughter the keeper.
Right.
Well, she's on her own. She does her training. But I started training my girls, you know, and
okay.
they love it. It's just to get them moving. There's not enough time at a youth training to just segregate the keeper.
Right, right, right.
Because you try to fit it in. You only got,
yep.
and, you know, at this age, you're developing them into more and more of an all-around player.
Okay.
You can't pigeonhole them at 9 years old and 10
no.
years old to say you're a keeper.
Right.
They love playing it. I give them, I split. I try to split them. Fortunately for me, I have two keepers.
Right.
But, you know, in certain games, my newer keeper knows. She might not get in the second half if it's a tight game,
right.
but she goes in and plays defense because
okay.
she wants to play
right.
defense. She likes it. She gets them to understand the game.
That's a good
thing.
So
we get out there and we
yeah.
play, you know.
All right, so let's just get right into professional side of things, I guess, right?
Yeah, we might as well jump in. There's not
we got nothing else going on. We may have a caller, the usual Vincenzo, you
okay.
know. We may have him in a few
Joe
minutes.
Joe just mentioned that what he gets worried about is that he's going to become more of a turf team.
Right.
And when he means
right.
turf, he means the AstroTurf.
Right. Yep.
And that's the hard part. That's a different aspect of a game, playing on turf.
It's a different game.
There's nothing, it's a totally different
right.
game.
Yep.
There's
yep.
balls bounce higher, you know.
It's the way the ball bounces.
So,
that's what makes it different, yeah.
yeah.
I mean,
and then Joe goes in and follows up with Uwe. So we can start off right
no,
there.
No, no, let's start off with the stuff that we don't know really much about.
Okay.
Just so we could wrap that up.
Right.
I think
that's fine because we could get caught up in that
right,
for a while.
The Cosmos. We don't,
what about
we don't know much about them, but they won their last game against Miami last week.
I know they used to have some guy that everybody had a crush on last year, Raul, but he
yeah,
retired.
Yeah.
So
the Cosmos still doing that thing in Coney Island, right?
Yeah.
Right?
Listen, I watched that. I actually watched to see what they did with the field.
The home opener,
just
right.
to see what they
right.
– And I guess it's because they're not playing. They don't play until, you know, Memorial Day or whatever it is.
Right,
the baseball
right.
team. They use the entire field.
Okay.
Like they laid turf over the whole. There's no infield. There's no
right.
nothing. So it's actually a bigger field
they
than
covered,
what New York City FC
right.
plays on. It's a smaller stadium, but they're able to get more field.
They're not messing around with that field at Yankee
it.
Stadium.
No,
right.
they can't.
So Cosmos. I believe they're 2-2.
Oh, well, I don't even.
I believe that's their record. I may be wrong, but I know they won two games.
I have to do a better job of checking up on.
So, all right, not much to really talk about the Cosmos. Let's go right into Body.
You really want to go there?
Well, yeah. We're just gonna wrap them up real quick. I mean, they played today,
and
they dropped.
Lost, right?
They dropped. Yeah, they lost 2-0 today, and they dropped themselves further down on the table had. They're sitting at number 11. Look, we have to flip the page over.
Right. Right? And they were sitting.
They were sitting pretty a couple months ago at the fifth, in the fifth spot. But now, as you can see, they're in number 11. And I think they're doomed. They're done. Total disgrace. I mean, it is what it is with this team. I think they're just happy with Serie B.
But how can you be happy staying where you are?
I don't know if they have any money to purchase players, and they're just doing fine the way they're doing now. They'll get lucky every 10 years maybe and raise a
come on,
a
they
Cassano.
Gotta have money sitting in the kitty.
Yeah, they may, but they're not spending it.
But
they're not spending it. It may be like every once in 20 years that they'll have a great player, but then they'll sell them. Obviously you can't afford to keep them.
Yeah, and we were talking about this before the show. But, you make a push, get the city off for one year.
Yeah.
You're gonna have the Juventus coming in. You're gonna have all the AC Milan coming. They're gonna come to your stadium. So that means the fans are coming to the town, staying in the hotels, eating in the restaurants.
It generates
at least some money.
Yeah.
I mean, you gotta do something.
This coming weekend, they're playing the second place team, Verona.
Okay.
There's no way to get points out of that match. So, as far as I'm concerned, FC Body is just about done. You could put the nail in the coffin there.
Right. Right.
So they're just about done, and we can move on from that. That's why I just wanted to wrap up the quick things because there's really not much to say with those two clubs. The Cosmos, we don't know really much about them, and Body. Good luck to you guys for the last five games.
Right.
All right. We got Vincenzo. I really don't want to talk too much about the Italians, Serie A, until he gets on. Is there anything else we could cover before that? MLS?
You got there right there. We'll lead it into MLS.
Right, okay.
Real Madrid, I saw this, but Real Madrid's going to play in MLS, MLS All-Star game.
What do you take?
Really, an All-Star? I know it's what we do here, but it's not and even the four major sports of the United States, their All-Star games aren't the same. It's more of the skills competitions that everybody stays, really watches.
Right.
Now you're going to have Real Madrid. Now, let's be honest. Who from Real Madrid is going to come in here?
Well, they're talking about everyone's coming in. They're talking about everybody's coming out. Now, don't forget, in July, is it mid-July, the All-Star game?
Yeah,
I think it's mid-July. That's their preseason.
Yeah,
keep that in mind. So you're gonna need
your
play.
Now let's be honest. You bring in a fully stocked Real Madrid to play MLS, the MLS.
Gonna be a joke. I think it's a joke. I think they're gonna embarrass the MLS players.
Granted, the fans will love it because they get to see Real Madrid with all its players there.
Right, and that's why.
And it's a moneymaker.
It's a win-win as far as that goes. MLS is gonna sell tickets. Real Madrid is going to get. It's a preseason game for them. They're in preseason mode in mid-July.
I get it, but that's just once again the MLS an All-Star game.
Right.
An All-Star game.
Yeah, it doesn't happen
in
Europe.
This is the same league that doesn't take a break for international qualifying.
Right. Yeah. Although a lot of teams did.
Well, it was
weekend.
Scheduling.
Right, right.
It was scheduling. It's not that they took a whole break.
No, they didn't. The league didn't shut down. You're right. Because as you can see the standings here, we got, some clubs played seven games, some played six, one played even five.
Right.
Okay? So some clubs were off that weekend when the United States played their qualifying matches.
And Joe's right. Maybe they will bring in Raul to bring him back from retirement. Since it's in the U.S., he'll come and play a little scrimmage. Yeah. That'd be great.
Yeah, I mean.
I know a couple of people that'll be making a trip out to Chicago to go see Raul.
Who did they play last season? The MLS, was it
John, to be honest, I don't know.
But they lost. They lose these games. They can't play with these top, players. These top teams, so we'll see how that goes. Look, the MLS is selling tickets. The fans get to see the pretty boy.
They're selling tickets. They get to see the pretty boy.
If he comes down, like you said,
he might not even come. But to be honest with you, I'd rather see a Marcelo play. You come and see them. Kayla Navas in goal to see that. That's different.
Yeah.
So who knows? Who knows?
They made it like a big announcement on, I think, over the weekend. It was like this big thing, that they announced that they were playing Real Madrid. So let's take a look at the standings. And then we got some scores to go over. After seven games, is this Columbus team for real?
Again, it's seven games.
Have you seen? Well, you
I know. Haven't got to see them play yet. I've got to see Orlando play.
Right. Orlando seems to be a powerhouse at home.
Yeah, and it's, you know.
Right. It's like a home cooking type of thing there.
You know, and it looks like Atlanta is starting to, you know, go through their woes six games in. Now they drop, right. you know, drop right. down to sixth. And again, it's going to go and.
Expansion team.
It's going to happen.
Right. Well, every team goes through their bumps throughout the season.
Oh, yeah.
We know that. All right, we got some scores from last weekend. All right, we can go over the scores. We'll start with Friday night's. All right, New York City FC. What is going on with Philadelphia? Did you catch that game?
Is that the game that was it Friday night?
Friday night, right. Friday night.
Is that the game he scored, Vila scored from
that
50 yards or whatever it was?
Right, right. Now, he says, you know, he was tired, so he couldn't run the rest of the field, so he just shot the ball.
I used that as a teaching tool.
That's what he said.
And something for my daughter as the keeper, and I said, listen, even professionals get beat.
But hold on a second.
You can't defend it.
You know,
but
the announcers are praising that keeper. All right, forget his name from Philly.
I don't know.
Whatever his name is, all due respect.
I know who he is.
Now, they're talking about European scouts watching this guy. Not when he does something like that. Are you kidding me? They probably just jinxed the guy. I mean,
that's it. He might have had European scouts looking at him, but
that's what they're talking about. Like one of the best keepers in the league, but you can't be off your line like that.
And get caught. You can be off your line, but you can't get caught off your line.
But you got to see the ball coming. You got to get
it
back.
He didn't kick a missile. He didn't kick the line drive. He lobbed it. So you actually were able to see that to get back at your line and be where you needed to be.
Being a former keeper, I think you could have had enough time to get back there because it was so far out. But again, you know what? All right, we might have a caller on the line. You're on the Staten Island Soccer Report.
Hey, Johnny.
It's Vincenzo. All right, Vincenzo.
Walk away from that microwave.
All right, Vincenzo, how are you?
Okay. Doing at the studio.
Very good. How you doing, Vincenzo?
You guys watching any soccer game lately?
We were just talking about New York City FC on Friday night.
Okay.
Did you watch that game?
I just had my son was watching, and I watched a little bit. I was late, and then I had to go someplace else. So what was the final score, Johnny?
Well, New York City beat Philadelphia 2-0 Friday night.
It's a classic score, 2-0, everybody's happy.
Yeah, it was actually 1-0 for most of the game, and then they scored a goal late there. David Villa from 55 yards away, he scored the goal.
Those are rare goals, appreciate.
Right. So both New York teams won this weekend. Brian is a Red Bull supporter.
Yes, I am.
And they beat Washington. They beat D.C.
They beat D.C.
United.
Which, again, I don't know what's going on with that.
Well, that's a rival, right?
For years,
you guys have been battling. So anytime you can beat them, it's a good thing. So both teams, and I think I'd like to see both teams playing well and making the playoffs every year.
Especially.
At the soccer that we're doing, a lot of kids, they want to go see the Cosmos,
yeah.
Because they're located in, the Cyclone Stadium.
Right.
Which is accessible, trains, buses, you know. So they're very anxious to go see the. So they are really making a summer schedule.
Okay.
They want to see at least one or two games.
All right. That's great for the kids to go see them.
Yeah, because you
Where do they train?
You have the ride, you got the beach, you got everything.
Right. You can make it a day, a whole day.
A day, family day. Yeah, I like that, you know.
And the tickets are only $10.
Yeah, the tickets are, they're reasonable.
Yeah.
So,
That's a good deal.
You should get preferential treatment, Vincenzo. You're soccer royalty in Brooklyn. Come on.
I don't know, but I know my son goes steady. One day, I'll take care of you, the ticket, the food, anything I want.
Nice.
Tell Joe that not to forget about me.
Well, I don't know. He says, are you the brother or what are you?
I'm the long-lost cousin.
Lost cousin. I'm long away.
I'll see you guys on Saturday night anyway. I'm coming down to check out the
semifinal, right?
You guys have semifinal.
Yeah, Saturday is the final semifinal.
Yep.
All these are two games, excellent games. Is Napoli.
Okay, I expect Vincenzo, one second. Let's get it right. This is the Fial Indoor Soccer.
Indoor Soccer semifinal,
okay.
April 22nd.
Right.
And the final, April 29th.
Okay.
At Cavallaro, located on Grazzi Avenue and 24th Avenue in Brooklyn.
Okay. Looking forward to seeing some good indoor soccer. Wrapping up.
In this group is competitive, John. The other group, just it's an instructional league, instructional practice, everything else. But in this group, you know, they play for the points, they play for first place medal. It's something, you know.
All right. Yeah, I always thought, Vincenzo, it's a good thing to play for something. If you're gonna have, if you're gonna keep standings and you're gonna have a referee, you might as well reward the team that finishes in first. But you might as well, you know, why not?
Well, I'm more like in the over 10 kids, because under 10 the kids, you know, let them learn the game, the passion, the love, and then over 10, they know, you know, they get to know. There is a reward if you do something or whatever.
Okay.
You know, you have to be careful in the age group.
Right. Okay, Vincenzo, we got one of the bigger games coming up on Wednesday. We're talking about the Champions League.
You went to Barcelona.
Yes, so give us...
Barcelona, you went. They play in Barcelona.
Yes.
Right. So give us your take on this game coming up on Wednesday.
If you went to... the first goal, even if they lose 4-0, they in.
I mean,
4-1.
Right.
Yeah.
The idea is to score one goal, and then with the Juventus defense, I think the Juventus got one of the best defenses.
Yeah. Oh, I agree.
Yeah.
I think Juventus is not Paris Saint-Germain.
Right. Well, that's exactly it, Vincenzo. John and I were talking about that before the show. This is a little bit different than playing Paris Saint-Germain because Juventus has the defense behind it. But we were debating, do they come out? Do they have to come out in an attacking mode, or do they start from? Or do they start right away playing defense and just defending their lead?
Remember, Juventus, they have defense, they have midfield, and they have offense.
They got all three phases.
So even though it's not like Paris Saint-Germain, most of the team is offense, midfield, the mind, and defense. You know, me and John could play defense, we could do the same job they did.
Right.
I don't know about that, but my legs.
I mean, as a
joke. I know. Go ahead, Vincenzo.
And Juventus, you know, they have experienced defense. They have the, if you notice, they have the fullback. They are midfield, they are defense,
yep.
And they go up. And plus, they have Bonucci, Barzagli, Chiellini. You know, they're not
Chiellini,
young defense. They're experienced defense.
Chiellini, the goal scorer, huh, Vincenzo? He's always scoring. Right, he's always putting...
Nice.
Coming from the back line and scoring goals. Him and Bonucci, both of them.
That's right, the super goalie.
Well, listen. Right. You guys, anyone might say something about his age, but he did make an outstanding save. And
He's playing awesome.
He made a save. And, you know, say what you guys want. I'm not talking about you guys. But
remember,
but
goalie, you need reflex.
Right.
Well, if you are 40 years old and you play in the field, then you're in trouble. And
Goalie,
you could play until 50.
Well, you can play until, you know, you know, like you said, your reflexes and stuff. But
maybe in the old days when you just stood there.
Yeah.
He played until 44 years old.
But he's still showing that he could play. All right, so you got to play him. And they're giving him rest now. He didn't play Sunday in the league game.
Well, it makes sense. You got to give him rest.
Right. So he got his rest. So he's ready to go Wednesday.
He's got to be ready to go. And you know what? It's his experience. Joe, I'm not sure if he was talking about Chiellini or Buffon, but either way.
Well, probably Buffon.
Your experience is going to put you in the proper
Buffon, even with his age and everything, but if you have a strong defense, you don't have to be a super goalie.
Right.
But as long as you have the experience, is going to lead you to proper positioning.
Right. Yep.
Knowing, film study, learning, knowing these guys, and being able to do that, and that's going to help you to go along with it. And I honestly do not think it's going to be a repeat of what happened with PSG.
No.
I just don't think it.
Even if he went to Rose, would be 1-0 or be like 3-1. This is, like you said, a difference from the Paris Saint-Germain, because if you have a strong defense, you have him.
Right, exactly. Right. There you go. You got a tough defense, and if they break down, you got him right back there.
Right.
And if they beat him, they beat him. I still, again, if I'm making a team, he's the guy I'm building around.
It's a big comeback. I mean,
I'm taking him. If you're starting a team today, would you take him honestly?
Of course, I'd take him as my keeper.
Vincenzo, same thing, right? If you're starting a team and Buffon is there, would you pick him?
Again, Johnny.
You're going to get the point.
Do I have a strong defense in front of Buffon?
See?
Yes.
No, Vincenzo. Vincenzo.
Guys, I don't know.
Vincenzo, listen, the question is, would you pick Buffon? Forget the defense. Picking the goalkeepers first. Would you pick Gigi Buffon?
The experience and he has eye coordination for the ball.
Let's remember this, Barcelona.
Again, and you don't know what's going to happen, but they got Tiki-Taka on their side.
Yep.
And as long as you play Tiki-Taka, eventually it's going to produce a goal.
That Tiki-Taka, I don't know if he's quick enough for that.
That's when they get Tiki-Taka.
Hey, listen, we said it in the other round, right? If there's any team that could score goals, it's Barcelona.
Well, that's it.
They were down 4-0. Right. We said that, right, Vincenzo?
Yeah.
So if there's any team that could come back from the 3, it's them.
But Juventus, I understand.
Everyone could have a bad game. That's why we play them.
Well, look, they scored 3 goals. I mean, Juventus is on a roll, but they did score 3 goals against Barcelona,
who's usually
possession-oriented, and they were giving the ball away, and they got capitalized on mistakes.
So there you go. I mean, if they stayed away.
I'm going to tell you this. They didn't play. They tried to, but it didn't work. They didn't play Tiki-Taka, and they lost.
All right.
Sometimes, John, there's no even defense. Sometimes who makes a difference in the game? A guy like Cuadrado, Lichtenstein, Sandro, these guys, if you notice, they're doing the hard work. They score the goal. But these guys there, if you notice, they're the one who helps the other player double up on Messi or double up on somebody. They're doing the dirty work unnoticed.
What about the young Argentinian for Juventus?
Dybala.
Oh, that kid is unbelievable.
He scored the 2 goals.
That kid is unbelievable.
He's going to take over Messi's spot on that national team.
Against Pescara, he got hurt.
Oh, he did get hurt?
Yeah.
What's his status? Do you know?
Well, the latest status, they win the game time.
Wow, they didn't say, wow.
Oh, that's not good.
Dybala is a great player, but Juventus, they have good substitution there.
Right. They got what we call two top teams.
Right, but again, that guy is on fire. You can't, to catch somebody who is on fire and replace, he may not play.
Right. It's probably a game time decision.
It's a game time decision.
Listen, this past weekend with Pescara, Juventus rested a bunch of guys. The defense, I know Buffon. Right.
Right.
I don't even know. Right, so I mean, you had to play the kid.
You had to put the kid, everybody else.
And he's a kid, right? So you got to play the guy. So, anyway, let's hope he plays. What a threat he is, boy! All right, Vincent.
The other game is also a good game. Real Madrid against Bayern Munich.
Momentum. Yep.
Yeah.
Yeah. Believe me, it's like those games happen to. Not too many times. Every year you have a good team and a weaker team. When you have two strong teams playing each other, like you went to Barcelona, Real Madrid.
We had Bayern Munich was leading in that game. At halftime.
Nothing.
At halftime, and then Real, right, came back and scored. The pretty boy scored two goals.
Yeah.
I like to call him the pretty boy.
The pretty boy, they were saying. The pretty boy. Oh, he's got more. Yeah, he's got more goals. I saw the stat. He's got 100 and something.
Yeah.
He's got 90-something goals in whatever number of games. Meanwhile, Messi's not far behind him in, like, 20 or 30 less games in UEFA.
But can we count the competition? Who'd he score those goals against? You know, right? That matters, too. But anyway.
These two games that are going on, and these are still the quarters, right?
This is the quarter, yeah.
So just this year you would think would be the semis.
Right, right. Well, 2 years ago,
it was
the final.
You know, the other thing we got to look at, and Joe mentioned it, he was popping up a couple of posts, and I noticed it. Borussia Dortmund, they're playing too, and Pulisic, you know, I saw rumors today reading the transfer wire, possible thought to him going to Tottenham.
Tottenham, okay, good.
Which I find hard to believe unless they're going to get a pretty penny for him because he grew up in the Borussia, the Dortmund baseball team, farm system or academy system. So I see him going, but that's
all right, let's get on. Vincenzo, what else is going on in Serie A? Let's wrap up.
I was watching the game, I believe it was Saturday, and it was Inter against Milan.
Right.
2-2.
Yes.
And then, you know, the referee, I don't know if I was, he went above and behind the 5 minutes extra time.
Oh.
Game left 7 minutes, the extra time. And on the last second.
Right.
Was that a goal? The ball went over the line. The naked eye couldn't do nothing. But they went to the latest technical machinery they have in the field, and the goal clearly went over the line.
So they went on a replay?
Yes.
They went to, well.
Replay now? I thought they only had the goal line.
Maybe that's what he's talking about, the goal line.
But. Over the line. But then, with the naked eye, you cannot see nothing.
Right, okay.
So they had the goal.
Whoever was in charge of the instant replay, he communicated with the referee.
Okay.
It's a goal.
And he called it a goal.
He scored a goal, the game is over. Okay.
All right.
Wow.
The game was supposed to be over when Milan played, took the corner kick.
Okay.
And then it was expired. Johnny, you were the referee there.
Yeah,
you
right.
You called the game or you let it go?
You got to let the play go.
The corner kick go.
I think I'm going to let it go. That's what I... Yeah.
It's not just a throw in there, Milan, see?
It was not the derby of Milan.
Right.
The derby made in China. Because the owner of Inter is Chinese and the owner of Milan is Chinese.
It's Chinese, wow.
Oh, wow.
So there's no longer Milan Derby.
Times. Times have changed, huh, Vincenzo?
That's right.
Times have changed.
Money City. Talks.
Hey, listen, just to change the subject for 1 second. Body played today, lost again 2-0, and I think they're done, Vincenzo. There's no chance for. I mean, there's still mathematically a chance, but I don't see them making the playoffs this year.
You know, John, what I notice, I catch a little bit the news, the Serie B. They have a lot of good teams there.
Yeah.
Just not body.
They
used to play
in Serie A a couple years ago.
Yeah, right.
It's not like, there is a good competition going on.
Yeah, those teams, Vincenzo, those teams won Serie A last year. They came back to B, and they're going to go back.
Right.
Yeah, that's
exactly it.
So it's the same teams going back and
they'll
forth.
Make their
back,
money.
Back and forth,
come
you know.
Back.
So anyway, body, unless somebody comes here or calls me from body and tells me different, I think they're happy, content, being in Serie B, and that's it.
Well, John, the only way they can win if a fan from New York City or Brooklyn or Staten Island goes there with a sign, solo body.
Yeah.
Then they're gonna win again.
Listen, I've done my share of supporting them from here, but it doesn't seem to be working. Anyway, Vincenzo, one more thing on Juventus. They got a chance to win all three cups, right? Serie A.
Juventus, I think they have Serie A, you could put a dollar, you could going to win the title.
Right.
What about Coppa Italia?
I think if they have to give up something, it will be Coppa Italia.
Who's going to? Who are they playing against? Do you know?
I think they're the latest stages.
No, they're in the final. Right now is the final already.
Final Coppa Italia.
Yeah, I don't know. Maybe Roma. I don't know. We'll look into that after.
Yeah, I think I.
Coppa Italia. I will put my Scudetto and the championship. You want to get all three of them, right?
Yeah.
Right. But if you got to give one up, you're giving up Coppa Italia.
I think I would say two out of three is not bad, honey.
So two out of three so far, it looks like they're going to get, they hope that they can win the Champions League. That's what they're hoping for, right?
If they had to give up two, they give up the Italian Scudetto, and they give up the Coppa Italia, but not the Championship.
All right, Vincenzo, anything else here? We're going to wrap up. We got some video to show. I want to show.
Vincenzo, I'll see you guys Saturday.
Yes, sir. I'll see you Saturday night.
You too, Johnny.
All right, ciao. No, of course. We never leave home without the whistle and my red card.
Okay.
All right.
Thank you. Ciao, everybody.
Thank you, Vincenzo.
Take care, Vincenzo.
Ciao, bye.
Once again, the Hall of Famer. And looks like Marco might have joined us on it. Okay. If the control room has a Roland, maybe we want to just show highlights from today's body debacle.
Yeah.
Let's just show a couple of the highlights there, just so the viewers get a taste of how bad this team really is.
Illusione ai tifosi baresi, la squadra di Mister Colantuono subisce un'altra sconfitta esterna a Carpi per 2-0. La cronaca di Samuele Amadori.
We're just showing
Carpi
a quick
batte
video.
Carpi batte il Bari al Cavassi con un gol per tempo. Lo supera in classifica, agganciando la zona playoff. I pugliesi perdono Floro Flores durante il riscaldamento per un indurimento muscolare e al suo posto scende in campo Manier. I galletti iniziano meglio dei padroni di casa e al sesto si rendono subito pericolosi con Galano, che racchiude un pallone a centro aria e scarica in porta. Vélez è concentrato e salva. Emiliani, maglia bianca, in vantaggio al 18esimo. Torucci anticipa Lasagna lanciando verso Michele, ma sfodera un pallonetto che finisce in rete. I biancorossi di casa provano a chiuderla tre minuti dopo, quando Lasagna mette in mezzo e Compass con il Bretaglio prova ad arrivarci.
I know they had an own goal scored against them too. The first one was an own goal, 7 minutes in. All right, control room, we could come back to... I really don't want to bore
John
the fans.
We don't want to lose
any viewers showing body, but I had to show a little clip of that, you know, the game from today. So we'll move on from the Italian leagues, all right? And let's talk about the I had it right here, the English Premier League a little bit.
Okay, before we jump in, I was mentioning it to you, and I looked it. I had to look it up.
Okay.
Yeah. I heard it on ESPN, and I just looked it up. Apparently, a Panamanian international soccer player, the midfielder, was shot and killed by fans this past weekend. I guess he didn't play well. And then there was another one in Argentina. A 22-year-old fan was pushed over the top rail at the arena by the opposing team's fans. Right. So, I mean... I used to hear about this overseas, and it was the fans, but I mean, really, people you're shooting internet.
That's stuff that we don't want to hear. We don't want to see.
No, it's a shame.
You know what? Listen, it all comes. It's a game, but I think in Europe, it's more than that. I think.
Well, there's even said it with watching whatever game you were watching, and they set off the flares.
They're throwing flares. I mean, it happens a lot in
Europe.
And
it delays the game, and it just shuts everything down.
I think, I hate to say it, it's a way of life for them. It's like a normal thing for them to do that. I don't get it. Why are they letting them in?
But if they're getting in, it's security's supposed to be heightened after everything that happened in France when the bombs in the stadium.
There was a bomb last week in Germany.
Right.
By the bus.
I mean, really. I mean, that's the other thing. Last week, the Borussia Dortmund game is postponed a day because a bomb went off. I don't know if it was outside it or in it.
From what I understand, it was right outside the bus.
And one of the players, a former Barcelona guy, Marc Bartra, he got injured. So it's just sick, but let's get into Premier League, which is starting to heat up.
One more thing on that. I'm glad
that we don't get much of that or any of that here.
No.
In any sport.
In any sport. It's not.
There's no room for throwing flares.
There's the healthy. You know, except, I hate saying it, unless you go to Philadelphia and then the fans beat
throwing,
the crap.
But no, they're not throwing five.
No, but they'll beat the crap out of you.
Don't they have a cell in their stadium?
That was the old stadium. I don't know if they did it at the new one, the Link. I'm sure they did, should. But they're a bunch of animals down
All right.
there.
All right, so yeah, let's just touch on it. You know, and I printed this out because of Chelsea's game yesterday, and they lost to Man U. 2-0,
mm-hmm.
and that big 10-point lead that Chelsea had just a few weeks ago is down to four. So, I watched the game. Chelsea, I really don't know what their style really is as far as, like, I really couldn't tell if they were playing terrible. I didn't really see much. I just saw that Man U just, like, they looked more pumped and more ready for it. They were taking it to them.
Right.
So that being said, at the end of the game, Conte comes on and he takes all the blame for it. The coach is the reason. He didn't even say him. He just said the coach is the reason why we didn't play well today. He
right.
didn't have them ready. Long story short, because it was a long interview with him, the next six games, he says it's like a final for them.
So, okay. Well, that's it because they know they got, you got to keep the lead. And,
right.
you know, these other teams. And I got to watch a little bit of the Liverpool game. I tried to watch a little bit of everything. Just Liverpool looks good. Man City, I like watching Man City. I like, just the way they play.
Right.
You got Pep there, and I like Pep Guardiola, and the one player I like, De Bruyne, the kid, right. the Belgian kid. He's really good.
Okay.
But Manchester United, they're clicking. They're starting. Yep. It's going to happen.
The problem with them is they dug themselves a hole.
Well, they started out a little slow.
Yeah.
But you know what? Now you're getting Paul Pogba. You're getting, Rooney starting. He's playing a little bit that when he plays, he's there. But you got a force like Zlatan Ibrahimovic. And when that guy's on.
He didn't come on. They got his understudy that played 75 or 80 minutes of that game.
He mustn't have been ready.
He didn't play.
Something mustn't have been
so,
ready.
And he scored a goal.
Okay.
His backup. So,
well, that's still not going to change anything.
No,
that's your go-to guy,
and that's it. Right. So, and Rooney still plays?
He's there. He still plays.
Off the bench, maybe? Because I don't think he played yesterday.
He either starts and then is replaced.
Right. Yeah.
Maybe defensive, or he'll come in after, later on.
All right, so as far as Chelsea goes, again, that four-point lead. They just got to hold serve here. They got to win a couple
games.
Well,
that's it. And the biggest one, and I don't follow it, I got to do a little bit more reading on it, is Arsenal.
Right.
I know there's a lot of things I see out there calling for Arsene Wenger's head, I read something somewhere that, since Wenger has been with Arsenal, which is pretty much his whole career, they've never, and I could be wrong, but they never finished outside of the top four.
Okay.
They were always figured out either whether it's the top four or top five, and now they're sitting seven.
Yeah. Well, they're still.
And they're comfortable at seven. There's nobody,
The European champion.
The Europa Cup, the Europa Champions League. Yeah,
they're in that group right now, as you could see.
Right.
So the top three Champions League, this is a playoff to the
Champions. That's the playoff to the Champions League, they're there. But that's not But see, that's it. They don't want that. That's a failure to them if they make Europa.
No.
If they don't make Champions League, it's not worth it.
Yeah, well, they're not going to make it this year, so.
No, that's not going to happen.
All right, let's jump back to the MLS because we had Vincenzo call us in while we were discussing MLS.
Mm-hmm.
That Philadelphia, the keeper, we spoke about that, and that blunder was actually a blunder.
Right. That's exactly what it was.
It was a blunder on his part. So, Pirlo, after last Monday, and we had a show on Monday, I was really on Pirlo a little bit.
Right.
But he kind of played a good – he actually – lasted. They didn't put. They had the lead. That's probably the reason why he played a little bit more.
Because he's more of a holding midfielder,
and
he's back there playing defense.
And as far as the announcers going on Friday night, they were saying that they're going to stick with Pirlo. They're going to stick, you know, they believe in them.
Okay.
They understand that, you know, age and older and all that kind of stuff, but they're not going away with it. He's going to stick to the style, and that's it, with them.
And I like, not enough talking about him, but I like this kid, Jack Harris.
Yep.
Jack Harrison. Okay. The kid is good.
Right.
And the other thing is, you know, while we're here on MLS and time's running up, but just want to... Also kicked off this weekend was the NWSL.
Right. The women's
league. Women's league. And one of the things I noticed, not only do they have a TV deal now with Lifetime.
Lifetime, right.
And Lifetime's playing, you know, broadcasting one game a weekend live. There's another one I found, Go 90. It's a free app.
Yeah.
So, you know, you can watch all the games on there.
We're joined now by Eric from In the Bleachers, so he might have a little input here. So let's see what Eric. Welcome to the show.
Thank you, guys. How you guys?
How's everything going, Eric? Good to see you again.
Good to see you guys. All right, I was just finding out some news on the Premier League right now. Okay. Romelu Lukaku, the guy who scored 24 goals this current season for the Premier League's Everton, you know, the Toffees. Right. He wants a new deal, of course.
Okay.
However, he wants to go to the UEFA Champions League. His club is deterring him from doing that by slapping a huge $100 million pound transfer fee on him, deterring any organization from wanting to even get him at all. Because who's going to want to pay that type of money for this guy, even though he's an aggressive defender and goal scorer, and he's a nasty player. And he's only 23 years old, and he's got a good career ahead of him. But the fact of the matter is Everton is not going to let their golden goose go anywhere. And this is actually going to be the last year for John Terry of the Chelsea club right now. In 713 games spanning from 98 to 2017, he's had 66 career goals, Emirates Cup championships, other championships throughout the Premier League.
And hopefully he's going to go out with a title. And they're also in the running for the semifinal with the FA Cup.
Definitely.
So two more titles he could go out with.
That's that's definitely huge for them this year. And as for the Premier League is what, a month away from ending?
They're about six games to go.
Yeah.
And the MLS is just in its infancy right now. And the Red Bulls won yesterday. Huge victory for them. I don't know what fans you guys are of.
Well, we support soccer. You know, I support soccer. It doesn't really make a difference. I mean, as long as the sport's growing. Of course, I'd like to see both New York teams play well.
I can't say that. I like to see them play well, both New York teams, but I'm a Red Bull supporter.
Yeah.
But, you know, it's good for New York, and it's good for the sport if both teams succeed. So.
Oh, without a doubt.
It's good for the sport. That's the whole key. That's the whole key here. And we'd love to see both of them play for a Eastern Conference title, you know?
Without a doubt. I would love
to. For the right to play for the MLS Cup. We'd love to see that.
Yeah, no, it would be great.
It would really tear the city apart.
We'll go down there and we'll do a show from one of the stadiums.
Yeah. That would be awesome.
You know?
That would be awesome.
That would be awesome.
All right.
Thank you.
Thank you for your input. All right. We'll see you.
Thank you, guys.
In the Bleachers, where you can catch Eric every Monday night live at 7:30 or 7 o'clock. All right, he didn't hear me. All right, so.
But going back to that, since we had Eric jump in, but you know, I always promote there's no better way to learn the game. You know, outside, you can go to practice and train and this and play the game, but if you really want to get a good understanding of what you're supposed to do, how you're supposed to do it, is to watch the game.
I say goodnight to Joe.
Joe's coming out. Is to watch the game.
Yeah.
Whether it's male, female.
Yeah.
And for the girls, I always promote to my girls, watch soccer. There's no better time. And now with the women's team, used to be able to, they're doing a lot more Facebook Live.
Right.
They're doing YouTube Live. Yeah. But now they've partnered up with this Go 90.
Right.
It's a free app. I've watched pretty much every NWSL game that was not live on that wasn't on TV on there, as well as there's other games on it. And then the other thing that's been going on, and if people, Carly Lloyd and Alex Morgan are playing each other in the female, the women's, you know, UEFA Champions League.
Right.
And if you follow Manchester City women or Olympic Lion Ace women, they will you know, when it's time, they'll go live Facebook, right. And you'll be able to watch the game. And it's and it's good to watch. It's a different game than what we watch here.
Right, right.
And it's great to watch it. It's another way of learning. But the more you know, we need to build up women's soccer in the country. Yeah. It's they're already more popular as the national team,
right,
than the men's. We know that. But if we can promote that league and they start going and they, you know, more TV, the kids, you know, there's more girls playing.
The MLS has to have what I, you know,
what we talked about.
What would help is, right, they could back them, like I have a women's team for every men's team, have a women's team.
You got Manchester City.
Right.
Manchester City women. Right. Olympic Lionesses has Olympic Lionesses feminine. They,
and let them
and they
play.
They all have them out there. Borussia has them. Arsenal has them. So that's, you need to grab that and say, you know what? We're going to, you're not going to be the, you know, whether you're the Lady Red Bulls, whatever you want to call it. Yeah. You know,
let them play in the same stadium.
Bring them up. You know, no college. Don't have them play in a college stadium.
Even though they may not sell the stadiums out.
It doesn't matter. They were doing it with the USL.
Right.
Red Bulls, too. That's a USL.
Right.
They're not, I guarantee you, when they play. No, now the, I believe the Red Bulls, too, are now playing at Montclair State or whatever. So they're playing there, too. But when before they had their own stadium, they were playing at Red Bull Arena.
What are the crowds like in Europe for the women's side?
Let me tell you something.
Are they big?
They big?
I mean, because I really haven't noticed.
I'm sure they don't play in the same stadium they play in, but they're playing in a, you know, the games I watched, they played in an arena. It was a, it was a stadium. It wasn't, you know, a college stadium.
Like a 2,000-3,000 seater.
I mean, again, like I told you, I remember talking to somebody when I went to Sky Blue.
Right.
They don't
right.
hang around. There's no at the stadium where they play in Rutgers.
Yeah.
There's no underneath. There's no locker room. There's I mean there might be a meeting room that they can sit in as a locker room, but it doesn't have showers. It doesn't. So then when you're there, you're getting in a bus and like the away team is leaving from the stadium in their bus, still in their warm ups, sweaty as could be, to get back to the hotel and take a shower.
Not a good
That's
environment.
Not right.
Not good at all.
Right.
Not good. All right, let's just wrap it up with the Spanish league. I don't know if you know a lot.
La Liga.
I don't know if you know much about this league. I really don't. I know the teams. Barcelona's sitting in second place.
I mean, that's coming. I mean, and you got El Clasico coming up.
Right.
Which is, you know, for those of you who don't know, it's Real Madrid versus Barcelona.
Right.
You know.
So that game is basically for the.
That's pretty much. You know, they're coming here. I mean, Barcelona hasn't been the team that they've been in the past, they're losing. I mean, they lost to, I think it was Malaga. And, yeah, I mean, Malaga.
So what's the reason for Barcelona? Is it just age? Or they haven't lost any players, right?
No, they've lost some players, but I just don't. Who knows?
Well, where do you put Messi? Where do you put him as far as best player in the world type, you know?
Well, listen,
number one, where do you put him? Where does he stand in your mind?
Depends on what you look like. To me, I look at him as a more all-around player.
Right.
Yes, of course he wants the ball, but he's not afraid to give the ball.
So he's more of a playmaker now?
I think he's more of a playmaker who could put the ball in the net without batting an eye.
Right.
Whereas when you look at somebody like Pretty Boy.
Yeah, he just wants
Pretty
to.
Boy just wants the ball and wants to put the ball in the net.
Right.
And
then run to the camera.
And if somebody has a wide open shot and they take it and just happen to either get saved or miss, you see him throw up his hands all the time. So to me, right off the bat, I'm not going to take it away from him. The guy is a fantastic player.
Yeah.
But as an all-around player and teammate, I don't think he's.
Right.
And if you take that whole package in, I put Messi over
Ronaldo.
But if you're going to take, you know, the flash, the this, the that.
Yeah.
You know, when you need either one, when you need a goal.
Right.
I'm not going to turn either one of them.
No. Away. Right. Okay. So, all right. So. Yeah, as far as that, I guess they probably got about the same amount of games, 5-6 games to go in their season.
Oh yeah, they're pulling up because again they'll end May sometime, beginning of May, middle of May.
Right.
And then they go for their little break. They get their break in July. Right. They get a month off.
Okay.
Right? It's a month and a half.
Yeah. So. Yeah, it's not much. It's not much time off. I mean, they get like you said, a month of holiday time, what they call it in Europe. So we got about running down to about 2 minutes to go. About a couple of minutes. Any last words? I mean, for the viewers on Facebook and on television tonight, you can find us on the Facebook page, Staten Island Soccer Report.
I haven't had a chance to look in depth into it, but I think this was by far one of our better views. We had 43 views.
Midway through.
Yeah,
right, through the show.
And things might dropped off and this and that. I get that. You know, I don't know if they're unique viewers or if they just popped on and saw it.
Right.
But that's great. Keep it. That's what keeps us going. You know, we were here when it was low. When it was lower.
Hey, listen.
And we'll keep
doing
it.
Right. Without the viewers. Without the input here. I mean, we're really nothing. We're trying to get this game out there, to everybody.
Yeah, that's
you know?
It. It's just
nobody. There's no love for soccer in this country, and not as much as elsewhere.
And just trying to spread the information around and get people involved talking about it. Everybody plays soccer on Staten Island. Everybody plays soccer.
You know, since I can't play anymore, I might as well talk about it.
No, but we talk about it, and we invite anybody to come in interact with us on Facebook,
right?
Or call in.
We're always posting soccer news throughout the day.
We try to keep everything going.
Right? Whatever info we have, we'll post on the.
You got
Facebook
club events thing. Going on. You want to spread it out and help get.
Give us
message us. Let us know. You know.
You don't have to come on. You could call us up. There's
right.
We had a job.
People, I'm camera shy.
You don't know how many camera shy guys I've gotten over.
So call us up.
Yeah, call us up.
Interact with us on Facebook.
Right. Yep. We got Vincenzo that calls up.
Right. But definitely, if you have something going on with your soccer club, your soccer team, you want to promote it.
Well, anyone that comes on, we'll get a Staten Island Soccer Report T-shirt. So that's a little incentive.
I know, and we got to figure it out. We do have a couple. I know that we have the joint team of Holy Child and Richmond Town that we want, the boys. We want to get them on.
Right.
I know I also told Joe, and I know Joe's not listening, went to watch hockey. We want to get his boys on.
Yeah.
And I said that to him, so we got to figure out. We got to make sure we get the scheduling out there so we have the big studio.
Right.
But that, you know.
All right, so look for more shows coming up. We're going to be wrapping up momentarily. I think the music is going to come. I'm getting the signal from the controller to wrap it up, So, all right. So, Brian, again, great job, and thank you for coming on.
I love being on the show. It's great.
We just got a few seconds to go. Again, like our Facebook page, Staten Island Soccer Report.
That's true.
Look for the show. It airs every Monday night at 7:30. And all right, that's it. I think we're gonna have some of our soccer players come on.
Ariana just started playing soccer again.
Yeah.
Hopefully, maybe she'll like it enough and
go travel.
Want to try and play travel and try out for the freedom.
All right, we'll see you guys next time. Thank you.
Take care. Good night.
Pari unica e sola, pari nel nostro cuore, non ti lasceremo da sola, facci sognare ancora, facci gridare ancora,
facci gridare ancora,
pari nel nostro cuore.
Non ti lasceremo
da sola mai. Quanti viaggi con gli amici, tanti posti sconosciuti, tutti uniti, innamorati di un sogno. Canto sempre con orgoglio, anche quando sono stanco. Mai nessuno può distruggere il mio sogno. Pari grande amore, pari unica e sola.
pari nel nostro cuore, non ti lasceremo mai.